Rajasthan. The name itself creates in our minds the impression and images of vast expanses of dry sand dunes. The sky is full of scorching sun. The surroundings covered by dry thistles and thorny trees. Sandstorms and miles-long desolate and deserted areas.
Common perception about Rajasthan is, you know, it is all desert. However, the facts are not that way. Traditionally, people here have been quite friendly to the nature. They knew how to conserve water, how to conserve biodiversity, and live with the nature.
True, very true. Rajasthan has much more than that to offer. In this land full of surprises, there are miles-long stretches of forests where one can easily see a variety of wild animals rambling freely and fearlessly. Lush green forests, sky-high mountains ranges, and streams and rivers flowing with rippling sounds present a visual delight. In fact, the surroundings all around here present an amazing combination of the colors of nature. That is why every moment spent here amongst these enticing surroundings become the most memorable moments to be cherished for life. Everlasting moments. One of the most exciting features of Kumbhalgarh is its wildlife sanctuary. Situated about 65 kilometers from Udaipur on Udaipur-Pali and Jodhpur Highway, Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary is a unique place amidst green mountains and presents the most spectacular view of the forests and the wildlife of Rajasthan.
Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru had once said, and I quote, "It's much more exciting and difficult to shoot with a camera than with a gun." And I wish more and more adventurous young men would give up the gun in the favor of the camera. It were these very words of Pandit Nehru which inspired us to come amongst these green surroundings of Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary to see and have a feel of the creation of nature. Come, let us go.
Situated amongst the Aravalli range of mountains and spread over an area of 578 square kilometers, Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary falls partially under Rajasthan, Pali and Udaipur districts of Rajasthan. This wildlife sanctuary is the home to many of the endangered species.
These are the pug marks of a female bear. It's going from Sambiakot and Anikot towards the gate named Arit Pole. She's walking all alone on the edge of the road.
Bears are found in abundance in this region. Usually shy in nature, the vanmole or jungle broiler can also be easily seen. As per the survey done in the year 2011, Kumbhalgarh has more than 16,000 wild animals, owls, panthers, sambar, monkeys, and many more animals can be seen here thriving in the open. A sambal rehabilitation center has been developed here, where sambals habitual of living amongst the populated surroundings of human beings are being brought and acclimatized with the wild surroundings. Later on, these sambals are set free in these jungles to survive on their own and the local food available.
We are in a process of increasing the population of animals, herbivores, in these jungles, like by bringing the sambals from Delhi, Sarishka and other places. Since this used to be a tiger-ruled area, our main objective is to increase the herbivore population here in these jungles and then gradually introduce tiger after making it suitable for them to thrive upon.
This enclosure is made for the sambars. This is Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Range ka Van Khandana ka Van Kshetra.
This enclosure made for sambar falls under Rana Forest Range of Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary and is in front of Choti Hodi. The enclosure we have made is 20 by 20 meters, fenced up to 2.5 meters with thin shades and covered by dry grass. When we brought sambars from Golf Club Delhi, they were initially given glucose, a mixture of bread, cauliflower and cabbage on the first day to prevent a sudden change, as they were used to fruits and bread while in Delhi. Second day, we provided them with locally available vegetation like gular. They liked gular fruits the most.
Gular ke fruits ke baad humne bilpatra swagra diye. Bilpatra ke patte hain. Shambal ke us waqt shambal ki flowering aa rahi thi. Shambal ke phool diye inko. Plas ke phool diye. Kasnar ke phool diye.
Aur thereafter, they were also provided with bilpatra leaves, sample, kachnar and palash flowers and other vegetations like bear leaves, bonia variegata, bonia reseveta and other tree leaves.
They
started relishing the local vegetation and this local diet improved their health. We have so far released 32 out of 38 sambars brought here from Delhi. Six are still kept in supervision. Eight workers take care of them. Two collect food from the jungle, and six guards keep a constant vigil against leopard in the night, sitting on these machans made on high trees around the enclosure. These guards have been provided with torches and burn a bonfire down below. Similarly, we have erected grass sheds and provide ample drinking water from water pumps for them to have a feel of nature. We have tried to give a natural habitat look to the interior of the enclosure.
What about those 32 released? Do you track them?
Yes, some rangers track them to keep a watch on them. They have been since returning to water streams, moving around in the jungles and getting quite used to the natural habitat.
We have started restoring Kumbhalgarh Sanctuary National Park gradually to convert into a tiger reserve. First we have taken up Bokundra near Kota because that is in the direct passage line of Ranthambore. Second one is this one. Rajasthan was tiger rich, but as has happened in the entire country, there has been loss of tiger life. But having all that, with the growth of tiger population in Ranthambore, I am sure we will be able to bring Kumbhalgarh back as a tiger reserve.
चुनौतियाँ बहुत हैं और climatic जो conditions हैं उसके.
There are many challenges, but yes, because the survival rate of plantation has increased even in the adverse climatic conditions due to conservation, this has increased the confidence of outside agencies. They're coming up with the customized projects. This is the sixth project we have in our hand called Extended Arid Project. Earlier we used to monitor and execute projects through the One Suraksha Samiti. This project will be handed on society mode. Societies have been formed on district level and on central level. Project management unions will monitor the work. Every district will have one Suraksha Samiti. and we have selected an NGO too. We will do the micro planning first and then guide them to execute. First year is a preparatory year. We'll work for the 5 years and the rest 2 years will be maintenance or exit protocol.
This is Todgarh Ravli Wildlife Sanctuary. This too is connected with the Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary. In 1983 itself, this was declared as a wildlife sanctuary.
Yet another example of the rich and varied biodiversity of Rajasthan are these jungles of Todgarh.
Earlier, this jungle was famous throughout the world as a tiger reserve, which is authenticated by the decades-old visitor's book, well preserved here in this rest house. It carries the entries and the description of tiger hunters right up to the year 1960 and describes the details of the tigers and various other wild animals hunted in these jungles by these hunters.
Though we don't have any tigers in these jungles today, but other wild animals, birds and vegetation are in abundance. And the State Forest Department is doing its best to protect and conserve it at its best.
We are doing our best to increase the animal population and introducing wild animals to complete the food chain in protective reserves. We are watchful for hunters and prevent shootings in the jungles. The majority of the Forest Department workers and officers are trained and committed to bring harmony between humans and jungles.
It's due to the untiring conservation monitoring efforts of the Forest Department that around 5,500 different species of wild animals are thriving here. Situated amidst the mountain ranges of Aravali Todgarh Ravli Reserve is spread up to 500 square kilometers. This jungle maintains an ecosystem, that is why it gets lush green during monsoon while remains dry in rest of the months. This is Ranakpur, which is among the five main pilgrimages of Jain religion. Like Kumbhalgarh, it has a deer rehabilitation center where deers brought from well-populated areas are acclimatized to natural habitats and then set free in the surrounding jungles to live on their own.
We are bringing only those wildlife animals from outside which used to be native and existed here, because they like the habitat, mix up easily and increase their population.
These unique efforts of the Forest Department have rapidly increased the population of wild animals. These forest officers and workers are putting their wholehearted efforts into the conservation of the forest. Wild animals occupy a special place in their hearts. They paddle wheel of the well, called Rahat, in their local language to ensure regular water supply for their cared ones. This shows their empathy and love towards wild animals. It's due to their tireless efforts that the panther population is on the increase.
D-
You are in Beda area and are seeing the beautiful mountains of Jawai Dam region. We have acquired 30 square kilometers of this land into forest region in the past 6 months. We want to make it a leopard conservation reserve. In addition to that, we want to relocate Chinkara. We want to plant trees and herbs for herbivores, providing them ample opportunities to breed. This was once a panther-ruled area, but the panther used to kill the local cattle reared by the forest people. The obvious reaction of the forest people was to kill the panther by spraying pesticides on the dead bodies. But the initiation of ecotourism has changed their mindset, and they are now supporting our efforts, which have resulted in a rapid increase in leopard population from 4 to 8, especially in these mountains.
In the name of biodiversity project, 4 species have been selected. Special emphasis and budget is allocated for the conservation, propagation and development. In flora, Khejri is the lifeline of the desert. The local people use every part of it. We have allocated budget for this. Second is Rohida, which is popularly known as the Marwa teak and is the state flower of Rajasthan. 2 other species are in fauna. 1 is the great Indian bustard, our state bird, whose population is decreasing in numbers day by day. Its conservation and development will be ensured, and the provisions have been made. The second is the Chausenga, or the four-horned antelope, which was once easily visible in the sanctuaries and is now declining in numbers. Provisions have been made although to develop and conserve the species as well. Earlier we used to conserve all species, but now we have specifically focused on these 4, considering our understanding and experience in phase 2 of this biodiversity project with its unique.
This is Sita Mata Reserve, an unparalleled place spread over 400 square kilometers and is located in southwest region of Rajasthan in Pratapgarh district, where 3 mountain ranges meet here, namely Aravali, Vindhyachal and Plateau of Malwa, forming northwest border of tall sagwan trees.
Here in Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary, we have more than 850 species of plants which have been discovered so far. There are more than 30 species of mammals found here. 2 special species available here are the flying squirrel and Chausenga, or four-horned antelope. Besides, we have also panthers, jackals, hyenas, grey and red jungle fowl and many other species of wildlife in abundance. We have more than 100 Chausenga. These are found in dense forest where fruits and water is available in abundance. It's a frequent visitor of water sources, roams around and quenches thirst 3 to 5 times a day. This sanctuary has enough water, fruits and environment for its survival. We have more than 250 bird species. These include migratory and residents. Some examples are Asian fruit flycatcher, tree pie, drango, serpent eagle, white eye buzzard, and brown fish hole. In total, more than 250 species of migratory and resident birds have been taken into account. Biodiversity here is excellent. 5 evergreen rivers like Sita Mata, Tankia, Budho, Cheli, and Jakam flow here. Jakam Dam is there, which has a capacity of 6,000 MCFT and is spread up to 13 kilometers. The canal from this dam flows across this sanctuary.
Two rivers are
Two rivers never get dry. Water is found at every 30 to 40 meters. It has water spots every 50,100 and 200 meters. Natural water sources are in abundance. We have developed some water spots. There is no dearth of drinking water for the wild animals in this Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary.
These rocks, standing here in mid of the Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary, depict its religious importance. It is said that the mythological figure Shravan Kumar, during his journey taken up for the pilgrimage of his blind parents, had halted here for a while. That is why this place is known as Shravani Talab. Not only that, but seen here in this very sanctuary, these rocks full of carvings stand a testimony to the historical importance of this area.
More than 20 years now, the entire focus of Forest Department in Rajasthan has been working with the people to develop forest, to regenerate the forest areas where the density has fallen down, and also to develop new areas. We are also taking advantage of the traditional system of orans in Rajasthan. There has been socio-cultural belief that there is a sacred place in almost all villages of Rajasthan. So if that tradition is surviving for generations, why can't we develop and strengthen similar tradition and create people's involvement to develop forest areas wherein they learn to live with the byproduct of the forest instead of damaging the trees.
As the name Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary itself suggests, this area is related to the ancient mythological epic Ramayana. It is said that when Sita Mata had to separate from Lord Ram, that time Devi Sita, accompanied by Lakshman, came here and he left Lady Sita here in Valmiki Ashram. As per the belief of tribals living here, it is during her stay in Valmiki Ashram, she gave birth to two sons, Love and Kush. This banyan tree here, named Love Kush, this Valmiki Ashram, and this one, the Hanuman Temple, are said to be the remains of those days. It is said that when Lord Ram wanted to perform Raj Surya Yajna and sent out the horse with Hanuman, it was here that Love and Kush tied the horse along with Hanuman. When Lord Ram came to know about this, he came rushing to the ashram. Devi Sita told his sons about him. The horse was released and the yajna was performed and completed. It is also said that when all the work and responsibilities of Devi Sita were accomplished, Devi Sita requested the Mother Earth to absorb her. The earth listened to her and made way for her by getting divided in two parts near here. It is believed that the place where Devi Sita was taken in by the Mother Earth is this 700 meters long stretch of hill that had got divided and which can be seen even today. Further, the spot where Devi Sita got absorbed is believed to be these melted looking rocks seen here. There are two ponds on the foothills of this hill. One is called the Papkund and the other the Dharamkund. There is a belief that whoever comes here to visit first goes to the Papkund to get rid of his sins, and then he can take a dip in the Dharamkund before paying a visit to the Sita temple.
With such centuries-old strong ongoing beliefs about the bonds between Devi Sita and this place, it was but natural that this forest reserve of Pratapgarh was named after Devi Sita and called Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary. Right in the middle of this wildlife sanctuary is situated the Sita Mata temple, where people from faraway places come to the darshan of Devi Sita. Even today, this is one of the most important places of tourist interest in Pratapgarh, which is very fast becoming one of the most sought-after wildlife sanctuary for nature lovers because of the richness of its flora and fauna in the entire northern India.
Panther or flying squirrel or chausinga.
This sanctuary is known for panther, flying squirrel and chausinga. Flying squirrel was not the inhabitant of Rajasthan, but when all the three mountain ranges came merging here, namely Aravali, Vindhyachal and Plateau of Malwa, bringing together flora and fauna of north, west and south respectively. For flying squirrel sufficiently, high-rising trees like Mahua are required. It makes coter or nest in the holes of trees.
तो उस घर के अंदर फ्लाइंग स्क्विरल जो आराम से रह सकते हैं ये क्या नॉक्टर्नल है रात में
दिस इज अ नॉक्टर्नल स्पीसीज इट कम्स आउट ओनली एट डस्क एंड डॉन
और सनसेट और सूर्योदय दोनों के बीच में जब दिन बड़ा होता है या छोटा होता है तो उसके अनुसार ये वापस क्वार्टर में चली जाती है रात के समय बिल्कुल दिन और रात के संगम स्थल पे ये बाहर निकलती है फिर रात भर अपना खाना वाना लेती है और सुबह वापस इसमें चली जाती है
It's really important for knowing of the evolutionary stage of walking and flying. It can only glide from top to down, but cannot fly from ground to top. It has to crawl up the tree while going back to its quota.
So, काफी संख्या में हमारे यहाँ flying squirrel है.
Flying squirrel के लिए habitat बहुत बढ़िया है यहाँ पे जो उसको खाने के लिए चाहिए.
The local habitat is excellent for flying squirrel. Food is readily available. All factors are favorable. As per this year's census, 57 squirrels have been taken into account.
Each and every moment spent in these mesmerizing surroundings of the green treasures of Rajasthan leaves such an everlasting effect on the minds of the nature lovers that they feel forced to come back here again and again, year after year, to experience its bliss and solace. Thus, the moments spent here become the everlasting moments of their life.
So this was a first step towards a unique journey.
With this ends my journey full of excitement and adventure, which can only be experienced by coming here in person.
This was just a glimpse of our invaluable natural heritage.
I'm sure this must have been an enchanting journey for you too, and you too must be getting curious to have a feel of it.
There is still a lot more to know and to explore.
So, what are you waiting for? Come and have a feel of this journey, full of excitement and adventure.
So goodbye till we meet again.